Namaste everyone, this is Pooja. In today's video, we are going to talk about how to become a registered physiotherapist in Australia. I know, I usually talk about US and Canada because these are the countries I have been to. I have been a licensed physiotherapist in New York. I have been a resident physiotherapist in Canada. But I have friends, thankfully. I have this really close friend of mine, Ami, who is in Australia. And she was kind enough to sort of type out all the details that I needed for this video. This is going to be a brief video. I'll try to keep it under 10 minutes. This is for someone who is thinking about going to Australia and who is a physiotherapist or is planning to become a physiotherapist in Australia. So let's get started. So there are two ways in which a student or a physiotherapist who is coming to Australia can qualify to become a registered physiotherapist in Australia. The first, if you study in Australia, if you do a bachelor's in physiotherapy or a master's in physiotherapy. The second, if you do the standard assessment pathway. Now let's talk about these two in details. Now, if you're planning to study in Australia, if you're planning to do a master's in physiotherapy or a bachelor's in physiotherapy, the good news is you do not have to worry about the license exams. Once you are done with your programs, you can straight away move on and become a registered physiotherapist in Australia. However, there's a catch. First of all, make sure if you're doing a master's or a bachelor's, those courses are approved by AHPRA, that is Australian Health Practitioner Registration Agency. I'll have the link in the description. You could check their website and they have a list of colleges and physiotherapy programs that are approved by them. So first of all, make sure your courses are approved. Then the thing is, to get admission into these courses, you need 7 bands each in IELTS and PTE. Now the thing is, IELTS you can get, getting 7 bands in listening, reading is easy, but getting 7 bands in writing is a difficult task. So that is one thing that we have to be worried about. The second thing is that you need, if you have done your bachelor's of physiotherapy in India, now you want to do a master's of physiotherapy in Australia. For you to get admission, you'll have to have 70% or more score in every year of your bachelor's degree. So I have studied from India and I know getting 70%+ was difficult for me at that point in time. So getting it in every year is sort of difficult. Then the third thing is that these courses are expensive. These are university programs and these courses are expensive. So keeping these three things in mind, you need to decide if you want to go ahead with this pathway or not. If not, there's a second pathway. The second option is that you can do the standard assessment pathway through Australian Physiotherapy Council, APC. Now, I'm also from Ahmedabad Physiotherapy College and we called it APC as well. Shout out to my college. The thing is, yes, you need to make friends with Australian Physiotherapy Council because pretty much everything that you need to get done through the standard assessment, for the standard assessment pathway, is there on their website and you're doing pretty much everything through them. So the standard assessment pathway has 3 components. The first is the eligibility assessment. The second is your written assessment and the third is your practical assessment. Let's dive deep into all these 3. Now me and my friend, both of us, Ami, both of us have done our bachelor's from India. So this video would be, more relevant to Indian applicants. But again, if you are from any other country, just make sure you could tweak few details to your home country and pretty much this process stays the same. So for the eligibility assessment, what you need to do is you need to get all your documents. Let's say you have done your bachelor's from India and now you don't want to do, you are in Australia and you want to become a registered physiotherapist in Australia. So you need to get all your bachelor's in physiotherapy documents. So you need to have your degree, you also need to have your 4-year mark sheets, and along with that you need a registration in your home country. So for India, it's Indian Association of Physiotherapy, IAP registration, that is definitely needed to get through this process. Once you have these 3 things, you also need 7 bands each in IELTS or PTE. Then you get the eligibility assessment done. Once you are sort of, done with the eligibility assessment, you get an interim certificate that gives you the ability to work as a limited registration physiotherapist. That is, you can work as a physiotherapist, but you need some supervision. Now you get the certificate for 2 years, and that's a good thing because this is a physiotherapy position that you can work as a physiotherapist and sort of prepare yourself for your written assessment and your practical assessment, mostly for your practical assessment, because you'll be, seeing and treating patients in Australia under supervision. So the interim certificate that you get can be renewed. Let's say you are on your way to giving the exams and you need to renew it for a period of time, you can renew it. You would be registering yourself with AHPRA, that's Australian Health Practitioner Agency, Registration Agency. I know the full form, I'm going to use it. So you are going to be friends with the APC's website and AHPRA's website. You would be going to these websites a lot. So that being said, we are going to move on to our written assessment. So your written assessment is basically two multiple choice question exams. Each exam would have 60 questions and you need to score 500 out of 1000. 1000 is the total score and you need to score 500 and above to sort of clear these exams. The good news here is that you can give unlimited amount of trials. There is no limit to how many times you can give this exam. So that's one good thing. Moving on to the clinical assessment. We're almost done. Clinical assessment, and that's it. You are done. You are going to be a registered physiotherapist. So clinical assessment is broken down into three components. The first is musculoskeletal, the second is cardiorespi, and the third is neuro. So you are supposed to pass all these three components. The clinical exam is going to be a simulated exam. So there would be highly trained actors who would act as patients and you would be treating them. You would be providing patient education, safety, things like that. You would be evaluated. So clinical would be an in-person exam that you have to sort of, perform, and you would be evaluated on the basis of your performance. The thing to keep in mind here is that you have only two trials, and if you do not clear your clinical assessment in these two trials, then you start the process all over again. So you start again from eligibility assessment, then move on to written assessment, and then come back to clinical assessment. Once you are done, if you clear the clinical assessment in your first attempt, that's it, you are done. You are a registered physiotherapist in Australia. That being said, you also need to figure out how you're going to continue living in Australia, what are you going to do in terms of your immigration and things like that. But in terms of physiotherapy, you are all set once you get the license. Now, there's one more organization that you guys need to be aware about. That is AAPTA, that's Australian Association of Physiotherapists Trained Abroad. So this is a non-profit organization and they are doing a really great job of helping overseas trained physiotherapists, sort of guiding them if they are planning to go through their physiotherapy process in Australia. So this is an organization that you should be in touch with. They'll sort of mentor you, guide you, and sort of support you and provide you with the necessary resources that you need to get through this whole process of becoming a registered physiotherapist in Australia. For Indian applicants, there's one more thing that you need to keep in mind. Please make sure that you get your Indian Association of Physiotherapy registration done before you leave your home country, because once you are not in India, it just becomes a mess for your parents or your colleagues to sort of help you out with the registration. The other thing is, if you are an Indian applicant, you can give the written assessment from your home country. So you do not need to be present in Australia. You can do it from your home country. And for the clinical assessment, you'll have to come to Australia, but you can do one portion of it already in India. So that being said, I conclude my knowledge on how to become a registered physiotherapist in Australia. If you guys know more about this process, or if there are certain tips and tricks that you would want to share, please put it in the comment section below. I would really appreciate your contribution, and I'm sure all those who are watching this video will appreciate it as well. That being said, I am a physiotherapist and I usually talk about all things related to physiotherapy in US and Canada, but definitely I'm open to new ideas. So if you guys have something to share, please contact us. We would be glad to share your content. We would be glad to do an interview with you. And that being said, take care. I'll see you guys next video. And yeah, someone mentioned I say that being said a lot, so yeah, I do.